All right, you guys wanted it, so here's a filament episode on a material as far away from PLA as it gets. This is Taulman PCTPE. It's Taulman's take on flexible filaments, and it's quite the material. It's based on nylon, comes in this milky white color, and is definitely intended for high-end applications. It costs about 65 euros per kilogram, which is reasonable even if it's not exactly a bargain. For print settings, I tried out a range of settings as usual. These three benches were printed at 225, 240 and 250 degrees Celsius. Taulman actually recommends 230 degrees, but considering that the 3D benchy at 225 barely printed at all, I went with a more aggressive 250 degrees Celsius for the rest of the prints. Now, PCTPE seems to be a lot less sensitive to ambient moisture than other nylon filaments, so you can actually use it without a dry box and your finished prints will much less likely turn into a floppy mess over time. But I did have real issues getting it to stick to the print bed. Nylons don't like to adhere to stuff, and even a fresh layer of glue stick, which usually works for everything, didn't hold down the PCTPE well enough. Magigu are sponsoring the filament series, so of course I tried their adhesive, but on a PEI bed like on the Prusa Mark II, it acts more like a release agent than an adhesive. But what ultimately worked was Magigu on top of glue stick on top of PEI. The glue stick adheres to the PEI bed, and the Magigu sticks to both the glue stick and the part on top. And with the printer in an enclosure for extra ambient temperature, that worked out beautifully. Still, it's a real pain to get PCTPE to stick, and while it did print at full speed in the Mark II, other printers with a less well-restrained filament path might need some extra filament guidance or a slower print speed. The prints themselves look pretty nice. The surface finish is consistent and crisp. However, there's a hefty amount of stringing from the higher print temperature and some overheating artifacts, so maybe try printing with the part cooling fan on a higher setting. In the technical quality tests, it did perform reasonably well, and what I also like is that it doesn't have that typical harsh plastic feel to it. As we get to the mechanical tests, things get really interesting. And the more materials I test, the more I realize the strength scale might be a bit too short. PCTPE would get a whopping 9 stars if the scale didn't end at 5, and here's why. First of all, temperature stability. It's fantastic. Even though PCTPE is already a soft material at room temperature, under boiling water it actually stays more rigid than PLA or even PET. It's also the most impact resistant material I've tested so far, with one of the specimens absorbing the full 1.5 joule blow from the hammer, a first in the series. The vertical bend test sample didn't print right, but the horizontal one just kinked instead of cracking, but the pull test also shows the same thing. The layer strength specimen stretched to over 2 times its original length, and still supported over 30 kilograms of load at 66 pounds, which is even more impressive considering that the cross section has also thinned quite considerably. Layer adhesion is also impressively good, only beaten by another nylon. Again, PCTPE is easily the toughest material I've tested yet. It's not too soft and floppy, and it will hold its shape even under temperature. So, if you can live with the extra effort it takes to get PCTPE to stick to your print bed, then I can totally recommend it for technical applications. I think I'll be printing some hard drive vibration dampers from it. That's exactly the sort of application that's perfect for PCTPE. Again, thanks to Magigu for sponsoring this series. Also, check out the links in the video description if you want to get some PCTPE for yourself.